Hello friends, my name is Pradyuman and welcome to my channel VMwareNSXCloud, where I share step-by-step videos for VMware portfolio products. If you like what I shared in this video, feel free to hit the like button and subscribe because it helps me to grow the channel so I can continue to create quality content for you. In my previous videos, I have covered installation of physical ESXi host, configuration of management IP on physical host, configuration of underlay networking for nested DC, layer 3 services using CSR 1000 vRouter, and infrastructure services such as AD, DNS, and NTP using Microsoft Windows Server 2019. In this video, we will install nested ESXi for our virtual data center. As we are trying to create a nested data center which depicts a physical DC using single ESXi, we'll use the power of virtualization. We will install ESXi on a virtual machine, and we will install rest of the components on top of it. But please be aware that this is not supported by VMware, hence never try to run production on a nested environment. In order to create a nested ESXi host, we would log in onto physical ESXi and we will create a new virtual machine. Just right click on virtual machines, select option create register virtual machine. It will open new virtual machine wizard. Select first option to create a new VM and move to next screen. Assign a name to the nested ESXi and select the OS family as others. Guest OS should be ESXi version. In my case, it's version 7. Select data store to save virtual machine files. Move next and assign CPU, memory and boot disk to ESXi. Assign CPU in a way that you have same number of socket which you have on your physical host. Keep CPU hot add option enabled so that if in future you need to increase CPU on this machine, you can do it on the fly. Most important bit is to make sure that you enable hardware assisted virtualization to the guest OS. This allows our virtual ESXi host to work as a physical one. Assign memory based on availability, minimum 20 GB, and keep hot add option enabled. Assign space for boot disk and connect the network interface card to nested trunk port group. Add additional NIC cards and connect them to nested trunk port group as well. Review information and finish machine creation. It's time we boot our virtual machine and install ESXi on it. We need to mount ESXi ISO on this virtual machine, which is located on my desktop, which we cannot do with web console of the server. Hence, we will open VMRC console. With VMRC, we can mount ISO located on my desktop directly to the virtual machine. Under VMRC, select removable devices and connect ISO, which will allow you to browse your desktop files for the ISO. Locate the ISO and connect it to the virtual machine. Once you have connected ESXi ISO, restart virtual machine. It will boot host with ESXi ISO or installer. To install ESXi, follow on-screen instructions such as press enter to continue. Finally, press F11 to install ESXi to the boot drive. After successful installation, please press enter to restart the ESXi. Well, installation process for a physical server or a nested server is same. These are the same options which we get on a physical server as well. In every data center, we keep our infrastructure servers on management VLAN. Hence, we will wait for server to boot and then we will assign an IP of management VLAN on the server while configuring management network. It seems server install is almost complete. Now in order to configure, we will press F2 key and log into the server using root credentials. Once logged in, we get multiple options, but we will choose Configure Management Network. We just need to scroll down and hit Enter key on Configure Management Network. Now we will assign VLAN for our management network. However, if you are using workstation for this lab, do not assign VLAN here. In workstation, we just need to assign the IP from management VLAN, but we would not assign VLAN ID on the interfaces. As in workstation, we do not have VLAN feature available. It has fixed network types. We would assign static IP under IPv4 configuration. In my lab, I'm using 172.16.11.101 for the first host. You can choose your IP schema as you like. I have kept 172.16.11.100 for my vCenter. I would disable IPv6 on my lab hosts, but if you want, you can leave it enabled. It will not have any effect on our labs, so choice is yours. But make sure you assign DNS server IP, as that is important for name resolution. Along with, assign a name to the ESXi. Finally, configure your domain name and domain DNS suffix and hit enter to save domain name. Now our management network is configured. Press escape key to exit configuration and you will be asked to restart ESXi host if you chose to disable IPv6 like I did. But if you did otherwise, it will only ask you to restart management service. Now, depending on the available hardware resources, you should create more nested ESXi hosts by following the same steps shown in this video. Though, we need only two ESXi hosts to test vCenter functionality, we will still create at least three ESXi hosts, which will enable us for vSAN lab. You must be thinking that now vSAN supports two node cluster, then why am I saying we need three hosts? Well, the reason is even two node cluster needs a witness node, which makes it at least three virtual machines. So in both the cases, we need three VMs. Then why not only use the additional host? This decision I will leave on to you guys. I would prefer using three hosts instead of a witness VM. What would be your preferred option? Do let me know in the comment section. Once all three hosts are installed and configured, connect to each host using browser. As we have not created DNS records yet, please access using IP address. Well, this was the manual approach of creating nested ESXi. However, we can use a little bit of automation and ease our task of creating hosts every time we need to spin our lab from scratch. I would make another video showing how can we create and configure nested ESXi hosts with simple but effective PowerShell scripts. This was it for this video. Feel free to leave feedback and suggestions below in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe.